Hello, this is Robin Waters from Tech.eu, and I'm here with Florian Meissner. Can you quickly introduce yourself?
Hi guys, hi Robin, thanks for coming. My name is Florian Meissner, I'm the co-founder and CEO of EyeEm.
What's EyeEm?
Right, EyeEm is basically the world's leading mobile photography community marketplace for, well, the photographer inside all of us, simply.
So when you mention mobile community for photographers, a lot of people will say that you're just one of many. Mm-hmm. There's Instagram, there's a lot of others. And people always refer to you, well, tend to refer to you as Instagram of Europe. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's a fair comparison?
Well, it's actually not a comparison at all, because what you guys all know is that companies like in this photo sharing space, like Snapchat, Instagram, are more and more moving into the messaging or real-time communication space, which is great for us, because what we are is literally a photography company. And what we want to do is really build the next generation of content platform and photography, of photography platform worldwide. And so our vision from really early on, literally when we started 2.5 years ago, was seriously, there's billions of photos that we are creating on a daily basis, and we're creating a digital oblivion. And the real problem is not how to take a photo and apply a couple of gimmicky filters and annoy my friends on my social networks, but rather how to find the interesting bits, the quality photos that people are interested in, or actually even at the end are monetizable.
So 2013 was a pretty good year for EyeEm.
Correct.
Can you share some of the highlights?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, just looking a little bit at the numbers, when we grew from 1 million photographers in January to 10 actually, towards the end of 2013, which for us was an amazing challenge, both from a team size. We were still a very small team.
Is that 10 million active users?
It's actually 10 million photographers. So basically, and the amazing bit is we did that with a very small team, and from an infrastructure scaling perspective, this is amazing. But we haven't spent a single dollar in advertising or marketing efforts. So for us, this year was really the proof of our product and the community itself that's part of the global base.
It also paid off in a way, because you raised, I think in the summer, June or July.
That is correct.
You raised a $5 million round from Early Bird, I think it was.
That is correct. Early Bird, we're super, super happy to have them aboard. They're not only in Europe and globally, but also in Berlin, obviously, very, very active and super engaged fund. So, great. And all of our existing investors participated well in the round, which is nice. For us.
So when you raise money, obviously at some point you have to provide some level of return.
Yeah.
How do you plan to monetize? How do you plan to create value around the business?
Right. So we haven't really talked about that early on, but what we do is we actually are already making money since more than half a year. And that was mainly the main investment thesis, obviously, of these guys, because we already showed some really good proofs of concept there.
Is that through advertising, selling apps, or how do you monetize that?
Not at all. So the key fundamentally different concept for us and our community was, you guys might remember when Instagram actually announced their terms of service shift beginning of last year. And what they did actually, if you upload a photo to Facebook or Instagram, you grant them one royalty-free license of every single photo you take, which they can go and actually use whatever the ad campaigns and whatnot. And that resulted in a huge outburst in the photographers community, like real photographers community, and people not being very satisfied with that, as you can imagine.
Do you think that was a catalyst for your growth?
100% it was. And what we did, and what we always did, and what we still continue to do, is we gave a promise out to a community that we would never ever touch their photos or their copyrights without their consent. And in the end, actually giving them money for it. And that is the fundament for our business model as well. We are a media company, we are a content company that connects basically a new generation of photographers and enables them to sell their images to brands, agencies, designers, small businesses, individuals alike.
How does that work?
Right. So basically, as you can look at the model, it's pretty much twofold. So we already have several millions, tens of millions of images that we can actually offer to our clients, and where they can tap into and search for content and acquire. So basically the stock model, so to say.
Right.
But what gets really, really exciting is that we already obviously have a community community of millions of photographers where we can just like go to a brand like Nike or ASOS or Lufthansa and tell them, you know what, you need content right now in Brazil at the Copacabana on a beach with a palm tree in the back with like two girls wearing sneakers. Should be a black and white photo, maybe taken on Christmas after 4 p.m. Tell me any photo platform in the world that can deliver that in real time. We can.
Nice. You're a very technology heavy company. I think a lot of your staff are engineers and developers right now. Do you also license that technology out?
So we are very, very focused on building our core IP, right? And it's absolutely correct. Right now we are like 70% of the whole team is very, very, very good engineers. We have a very kick-ass design and product team and the community team, and so far it has been me running the business side of things. I just hired Dietmar Frohmann, who was the ex-general manager of Getty Images and Livestock Photo, and also built Fotolia in Europe, to lead our marketplace efforts in the next couple of weeks, which I'm very excited about.
Nice.
And obviously the next month for us will be towards focus on building out the business efforts, and that will reflect also in the team and the hiring.
Very cool. So you're based in Berlin. Obviously you have an international community base. Does that mean you're going to expand offices in other countries as well?
So speaking of the community, you're absolutely right. So the big five or six countries are basically US, it's Japan, Brazil is getting bigger and bigger for us.
Do you have offices there now? Do you plan to open offices at some point?
But I wouldn't say no to that
right. Makes sense. What about Berlin, the startup scene in general? Have you seen it evolve in 2013?
Sure.
And how do you think it will evolve in the future this year?
Absolutely. So, I mean, literally when I just look back at the year when we started, what fascinates me the most is that you for the first time already see certain learning cycles. So basically companies that didn't work out, companies that got acquired, or just people who tried something or didn't have like the actual incentive to found something, but at least started thinking about it. Now I'm able to be able to join companies like ours. And as we or guys at other companies basically getting to a certain size, have the resources to actually afford these kind of players, it's really, really good. And that's just for us the moment where we don't make any compromises on talent anymore, and which is really, really comfortable.
I'm not going to claim it's necessary, but do you think 2014 is going to be the year where we see the big exits of the WUGAs and the SoundClouds in this world?
So interesting, I get that question every year since a while. If 2013 or 14 is going to be the breakout year. No, it's not going to be the breakout year. We will need several years to actually shape that ecosystem and make it work and grow together. But commenting on the companies that you mentioned, I certainly believe in the continuing business value that these guys are creating, and I have very high, not hopes, but I'm very, very confident on their success, for sure.
Very cool. Thank you very much for your time, and best of luck with EyeEm.
Always welcome.